Hey everyone, I just wanted to do a quick little tutorial to show you guys the difference between how to get regular pictures, whether it's a PNG or a JPG file picture versus an SVG picture, how to get the drawings to show up because it's totally different between the two of them. And I had been asked to do this video, so I figured I would go ahead and create it. So let's get right to it. I took the liberty of uploading, as you can see, two of the exact same picture, okay? But they are different formats here. All right, so let me just show you real quick. If you bring an SVG file into Doodly and you add it in, I'm just gonna go ahead and make it a little bit larger here, okay? Then what you do is you would click on this little pencil icon. And in Doodly, you will see here, there is a feature. It comes free with your software, and it'll tell you, you can go ahead and load the SVG paths. So I'm gonna go ahead and click it, and real quick, let me just show you. If you don't do this, then it'll preview right here. You will see, it'll basically just kind of show up, all right? However, if you load the SVG paths, okay, click on it, click OK. And what's going to happen is now you're going to see it sort of draws it in for you. Okay, now different pictures are going to do some different things. What you would do is you would save and return. All right. And just to give it a better presentation here, I'll extend it to about 15 seconds. We will save it. And preview. And this is basically what it would look like if it were drawn in, okay? According to the SVG paths that are already in this picture. So you'll get, and the hand is moving a little slower, it always does when you're previewing in the software and it speeds up later on once it's been exported. So we'll go ahead, exit out of that. I'm gonna open up a new scene here. And I will show you the difference with a PNG. And it would work this way with a JPG as well. So I'm going to go ahead and make it bigger. So you would hit on the edit icon. All right. So as you can see, there are no loaded SVG paths that you can add in. In this case, if you are going to add in anything other, say, than an SVG, I'm sure there are some other files, but I'm just not sure what they are that would come with these paths loaded. You are going to have to create them yourself, okay? So as you can see, there's already a path here. And what you would do is you can make this a little bigger, make that a little smaller. This is going to be the size of your pen. Or pencil. It's basically going to be the size of the drawing, okay? So, and this is what you do. You can make it a little bit bigger if you want, just to get better view of what it is you are filling in, okay? So we'll just do a few of these, all right? And then you can see over here how it's basically going to look. And the beautiful thing about this is you can go ahead, like I can see over here, that is a little bit, well, unsolid. So you can kind of take it and move it in there a little bit. Really the idea is you want to have as much of the color in your dots as possible. So when you do that, then you can see it will fill in. I'd say give it one more time of doing that and you'll see it's probably, yeah, as you can see, it's more filled in. Okay, so we've got that. Now, just to show you, you can go ahead if you want to create a new path. Normally, I would finish what I'm doing, but just to show you how it works, so if you make it a little bit bigger, and let's go with the eye here, all right, you can see that it is quite a bit bigger. And you can do this if you want to create a bigger line, okay? And if you wanted to create some different effects, here I just added a different path. I might want to make that a little bit smaller and go in here. And it would look like that. Okay. Oops. Oh, and here, this is great because there was a mistake there. So I am going to go ahead. I'm going to hit the Control Z, and that just undid that last mistake. Okay. So that's basically how that works. All right. So with a PNG or a JPG file, you have to actually draw the paths in. All right. It's a little time consuming. It certainly takes a while. I actually like to do this kind of thing if I know I want to use pictures and they do not have SVG paths. And what I will do is I will put my headphones on and I will listen to music or listen to a podcast, and I will just upload these things and I'll create them in advance if I think it's something I'm going to use. Okay, so for example, I'll just save and return this. All right, so we'll add a new scene here. And I'm going to make this very quick. I'm not going to continue to do this for much longer because I don't want this to be a long, boring video. But this sofa here, okay? One night, I just felt like adding a few extra props in. So this very well could have been an SVG file. This is before I even knew that I had the option to do that kind of thing. But I took the liberty of going ahead and drawing this entire sofa in. And so that's just what I did. I sat there. I probably listened to some Michael McDonald because he's pretty badass. Even today, I love his music. And I was probably listening to him and drawing out this sofa. And so now if I have a video and I want to go ahead and use the sofa, then I will have it in there. Okay, and you'll see what it looks like. So this is what the SVG paths look like. They're already drawn in. Okay, I'm not in love with this one, but it's just an example. And before I end this video, I'll show you another one real quick that actually is a little bit better. This is me drawing the same picture, okay, which I really didn't draw. And then the sofa, this I actually did myself. This was possibly a PNG file, I'm not even sure, but I treated it like it was one and I drew it in myself. So that's how that works. I hope it's not too confusing. Let me quickly see if I have, maybe I can go to some of these characters here. All right, here's Angry Man. Okay, so Angry Man. Yep, all of these SVG paths are already loaded. Okay, so this would be a better example of an SVG file where the paths were done very, very well, all right? And if you added him in, I'm just going to go ahead and move him to the beginning so you don't have to preview all of these other ones all over again. All right, we'll save it. And this is what it would look like with an already done SVG path loaded into Doodly, all right? So, to summarize it, this guy, a pretty good example of an SVG picture with all of the paths already loaded. This one, not as great of an example, however, those paths were already loaded in. This one, this is a PNG file, and as you could see, I started to draw it in myself, and then this is another one I drew in myself, but it is completely finished. So there you have it. I hope that helps to explain a few things as far as where you can get images. I usually get my stuff from Pixabay because they're free, and they do actually have quite a few SVG files in there. However, of course, it's still going to be a little bit limited. And, you know, this guy was from a vector pack, this one as well. You know, I purchased a couple of those programs from I think it was JVZoo. Brad had sent out some emails before, you know, these people. And so you can always do it that way. But basically, you're pretty limitless when it comes to this sort of thing. You can go ahead. You can use any picture you want. It's just if you want it to be drawn in, again, if it isn't an SVG, you're going to have to draw it in yourself. I suggest, you know, relaxing and kind of getting into it and treating it like an art project, which is what I do. Or you can go ahead and try to find as many SVG files, which I also do to save some time. So there you have it. I hope that was helpful. I'm going to go ahead and get this uploaded shortly. And until next time, take care.